You have your Bibles. I'm going to be in Matthew chapter 2 today, verses 1 through 15. And going to speak on the subject of the joy of Christmas. And as I said, most of the time, this is the best time of the year, isn't it? People seem more in tune to one another than any time of the year. The joy of Christmas, if we could have it every day, wouldn't it be a wonderful world to live in? Yep, we wouldn't appreciate that. Good and the bad got to come together, doesn't it? Matthew chapter 2, 1 through 15. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born, king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when they had gathered all the chief priests and the scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for this is written by the prophets. And though Bethlehem is in the land of Judah, are not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of these shall come a governor, and there shall rule my people Israel." Then Herod, when he had heard privately, called the wise men and inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child. When you have found him, bring me the word again that I may come and worship him also." When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, fell down and worshiped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. And when they had departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, "Arise, and take the young child and his mother, and flee into Egypt, and be there until I bring thee word, for Herod will seek the young child to destroy him." When he arose, he took the young child and his mother by night, and departed into Egypt, and was there until the death of Herod, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, "Out of Egypt I have called my son." Once again, the joy of Christmas. During this time of the year, we usually hear many songs being sung. And Christmas time is supposed to be a joyful time, correct? Joyful time. So we hear these songs like, "It's the most wonderful time of the year." So Chris started it out. I'm going to finish it. Amen. Dad's going to finish it. And then we hear these songs, "Have a holly jolly Christmas, it's the best time of the year." And this old tone, y'all jump in here anytime now, all right? Y'all can do it with me, all right? And then we hear this song, "Chestnuts roasting, bean at my heels," all right? Then we hear this one, and everybody should be able to do this one. "Jingle bells, jingle bells." See, y'all are already getting into this. Joy of Christmas, right? I see some of you smiling, some of you say, "Oh, Lord." Yeah. But how about this one? "Walking along, singing a song, walking in a winter wonderland, gone away. Hear the song as we go along, walking in a winter wonderland." And we pretend that he is possum. He'll say, "Are you married? But you can do the job when you..." with all of those songs and all the joy that they bring. All the joy. It should be a trouble-free season, shouldn't it? I mean, we shouldn't have a care in the world. Everybody be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Y'all remember that old one? We should be happy. But that's not the case in most time, is it? It's not the case. Because some of us are experiencing problems. Some are experiencing the loss of a loved one, a friend, family member. For some of us, amen, we just got one crisis right after the other. It's hitting us. So the joy of Christmas has faded in the background of our lives, but at this moment in time, because of all of the situations that we find ourselves in. And when you find yourself in that situation, you got to get gloomy and doomy, don't you? Come on, help me out. Amen, oh me, oh my. So we got to find the joy of Christmas again. We have to find the joy, amen, of Christmas again. There is joy in Christmas. There is joy. And this is a joyful time of the year. The scripture that we read, it says that three wise men, three magi, began to search for the child that was being born here on earth. They were searching for the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. They wanted to worship him. They wanted to adore him. They wanted to find the real meaning of joy of life. They wanted, amen, to find him and worship him with all their heart, soul, and mind. And they brought special gifts to give to this baby that was born on that first Christmas morn. Glory to God, as they began to search, amen. And boy, I tell you what, the joy of Christmas can be found in what we are seeking. What are we seeking? The joy of Christmas can be found in what we're seeking. What were they seeking? They were seeking the Lord Jesus. They were seeking, amen, an individual they could worship and adore. They wanted, amen, that joy of Christmas. And so they were seeking for the Lord. But what are we seeking for today? What are we seeking in Christmas today? Are we seeking that nice gift that will tickle our fantasy, you know? Are we looking in the wrong place to bring that joy? Are we looking at for that joy of Christmas in an individual, family member, of the Christmas tree, the lights? Where are we seeking? What are we seeking? Where are we looking? Friend, we need to get back, amen, to the joy of Christmas. And that's finding the Lord Jesus Christ and worship him with our heart, soul, mind, and body and giving him our all in all. And it's only then when we find and seek him, amen, and honor him, will we find the joy of Christmas. We'll never find joy in life without him. We'll never find the joy of life without him. And boy, I tell you what, many folks today are searching the avenues of the world to find joy for life that only can be found in Christ. So the question is, what are you seeking? Because your level of joy at Christmas is directly related to what it is you seek. Not only was the wise men seeking the Lord to worship him, but they was looking for the opportunity to do so. And they were looking. They were looking. And a lot of times when we're looking to worship the one and only and true Lord, it can lead us down many avenues. Because many people are looking in the wrong places to worship the true and the living God. They're looking in the wrong places. Some look in the wrong churches. Uh-oh, wrong. You mean we got wrong churches? Absolutely, in this day and time we're living in. We got those out there who are preaching false doctrine. Stop heeding to the book. Amen, the written word of God, the truth. And Jesus once again said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no man can come to the Father except by me. The many who have strayed from the truths of this book and telling you there are many avenues that lead to the one you can worship and adore. And there's only one way that leads there. And that is through Jesus Christ, the one who was born, that the Magi's were searching for, the one and only, Jesus Christ. So we can look in the wrong places. So what are you looking? Where are you looking? Because your level of joy at Christmas is directly related to where you look. Listen, folks, amen, they looked in the wrong places at first. See, they were seeking a king, amen, one and only, the Lord Jesus Christ. But they thought he would be born in the city where kings would be born. So they went to Herod, amen, the kingdom there. And they searched for Jesus, but he wasn't there. So they inquired, where is he? Where is he? He's not in the hospital here. Where is he? Then the prophets were called in. And the prophet says, hey, look, the word of God tells us that he will be born in Bethlehem, a little obscured village, amen, out of town, in a nowhere place, if you will. Now, that's where he was going to be born, but they didn't realize he was going to be born in a little manger, in a stable, did they? And by the time the Magi, the wise men, got there, Christ is almost 2 years old by this time. He's living in a home. So they had to look, amen, not only in a small, obscured village, but they had to find the home where he now resides. But they looked, amen, they looked first in the wrong place. Then when they got the word, they went to where he was because they wanted to get their worship on, baby. Y'all got me? Amen. They wanted to get it on. They had been a traveling a long way and a long time, amen, looking and searching and seeking for the Lord Jesus Christ, who is able to take away the sins of the world. And glory to God, who had power to heal, amen, who had power to open the eyes of the blind, amen, make the deaf hear again. They was looking and searching for him, amen, who could set them free. Amen. And when they found him, amen, when they found him, they gave gifts that were appropriate. So what you seeking today? Where are you looking? And what do you have to give? I believe when we find a place where we need to worship, amen, in spirit and in truth, amen, we won't look in the wrong places any longer. We'll look at the right places. And we'll worship him in spirit and in truth. And we'll give the appropriate gifts. We'll give the appropriate gifts. What do you have to give? The wise men came to Jesus' house bearing gifts. The gifts they gave were entirely appropriate. They gave gifts of gold, and that was for a king. By giving it, they acknowledged that Jesus was and is king. They gave frankincense, a gift for a priest. This was incense the priest used in the temple. And by giving it, they acknowledged that Jesus was the high priest, the one who would bring us to God. They gave myrrh, the gift for death. That was a fragrant ornament used to anoint bodies before burial. By giving it, they acknowledged that Jesus Christ had come to die for the sins of the world. For the sins of the world. So you and I today, we ought to give the appropriate gift at Christmas as well. We might not have gold, frankincense, or myrrh, but we should give God us. And when I say give God us, that means give God everything. Of us, our time, our talent, our treasure, our testimony, everything that we are, give it to him. We owe it to him because he is the one who has extended life to you and I. And without him, we are nothing. Without him, we can do nothing. So we ought to give appropriate gift this Christmas as well. And those appropriate gifts will include love and kindness. It don't cost you anything to show those things, does it? A little love, a little kindness, and a little respect. I still believe in saying thank you. Yes, ma'am, no, ma'am. Yes, sir, no, sir. And I still believe, amen, you ought to respect those in authority. Regardless of the status of their situation, amen. Wherever they serve, we should respect. Love and kindness. To our friends, family members, to those around us. We should also help those who are hurting. We ought to pray for one another, encourage one another. And most of all, we ought to give the gift of forgiveness. After all, that's what Christ came to give to us. Forgiveness. Forgiveness to those who have hurt us, has done us wrong. Pray for them. But offer forgiveness as Christ offered you forgiveness. I believe the scripture tells us that we ought to forgive one another even as Christ forgave us. Aren't you glad he didn't hold anything against us? Gosh, if he held anything against me, I'd still be in a dying need, amen. But thank God for his forgiveness and mercy. And he wiped the slate clean. He said, I'll never bring it to my remembrance again. All the wrong that you ever done, I'll never bring it to my remembrance again. I'll cast it as far as east is from west. How far is east from west? You ever figure that out? You did, you're a genius. Because it's never ending. So it's cast as far as away as forever and forever means he'll never be remembered again. Thank God for that first Christmas morn. When Christ's child was born, because he loved me and he wanted to offer the gift of forgiveness to all who call on his name. If you call on the name of the Lord, thou shalt be saved. So what are you giving this year for Christmas? Why not consider giving yourself? Giving your time to your family. Give your compassion to the hurting. Give forgiveness to the ones who have wronged you. And most of all, give your heart to Jesus. I promise you, when you look for the right thing, and you look in the right places, and you give the right gift, your joy of Christmas will come. Because it's the most wonderful time of the year. Let us stand. Our Heavenly Father, God, as we come to you this morning, Lord, we're grateful and thankful, Lord, for your blessings you've stored upon us. Father, I thank you for this very simple message, Father. As the wise men began to seek. And they began to seek you, Lord. To worship you and to adore you. Father, may we do the same today. May we look in the right places and find you, Lord. And the right place to begin is in your word. May we find you every day of our lives, God. May we talk with you and walk with you. And may we give the appropriate gift today of ourselves to you that we will be able to give to others this Christmas season. God, the gift of love and forgiveness and mercy. That our Christmas will be filled with joy. Father, if any's in here are hurting today, God, whatever the need is, Father, they can find the joy today of Christmas here upon this altar as they turn those needs over to you, and Father, and begin to honor you, worship you, that the joy of Christmas may fill their lives. God, touch your people today. Friend, if God has spoken to you, this altar is open. You come all over the building.